you cry.
Everyone, hi, sorry about that not showing up on the stream. It was by Raw, Do You Call My Name? That's a good one of theirs, pretty much the most popular one. Another one I liked was Fallen Angels. Let me just hold on. Yeah. I see fallen angels as I'm walking in my sleep. Silently preparing what they'll do to me. Yeah. Anyway. Yeah, I used to listen to them all the time. Sorry about that. It's good shit. Hi. So, gang, I have a confession to make. This is gonna hurt. This is gonna hurt your feelings. But I think I'm gonna have to retrace my steps over the thing where I said I was gonna start a new series at the beginning of December. The problem with that is going to coincide along with both two series that are going to be starting up on the YouTube channel. One being the one that just started today, or yesterday, I guess now, which was the Night in the Woods with Angel. Two, To the Moon 2 comes out, I believe, next week. And I want to do that as well on top of that. So I can't do three streams on top of everything else that I already have doing. Or I'm sorry, three playthroughs on top of everything else I'm doing. So, what I'm gonna do is, when I finish one of those two, either Night in the Woods or To the Moon 2, then we'll do the near stream. I'm sorry. I bit off more than I can chew. I forgot that To the Moon 2 is coming out so soon. And kind of need to do that. It's like more of like, if I don't do it, then who am I as a person, sort of thing. You know? So, yeah. We'll have two playthroughs going up on YouTube. So right now, Twitch is just like a haven of random bullshit. Most notoriously, as of late, Yu-Gi-Oh, as you could probably tell, because it's just what I've been doing lately. What's To the Moon? Originally, To the Moon was a game, an RPG Maker game that I played many, 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 many moons ago. It was one of the first big games, or not big games, but one of the first big playthroughs, I guess, I ever had, where like, people actually, checked me out and shit. It was really nice, and the creator's a really good guy. His name is Ken Gao. He, we're chums, chumarinos. It was also one of the first, actually, the first game developer that ever actually sent me anything, which was super awesome for a budding YouTuber at the time. Yeah, he sent me music boxes based on the game. It was really, really cool that he did that. So I will always have a place in my heart for Mr. Ken Gao. That's why if I ever make a game, I'm gonna make sure that I see if he's down to do some music for it, because that would be hecka flippin' sweet, man. But in the meantime, you guys want to do some Yu-Gi-Oh? I do. Me, this guy here. I do. That's me. Hi. Now, I'm going to assume someone's going to be asking in chat, "Hey, Cry, but listen, guy, you're doing all these Yu-Gi-Oh streams. Why can't you just, instead of doing Yu-Gi-Oh, do Nier?" Well, the thing is, when we do a Twitch playthrough, we have a scheduled format for it, so we do it on an actual consistent basis. These Yu-Gi-Oh streams are far from scheduled. You think we got schedules for these things? Pfft, shit. This is just whenever the fuck it goes down. You feel me, dog? Shit. I did some farming, by the way. Let me go ahead and put on some jams real quick. Let's try something different today. We usually do lo-fi shit. Wait, what is this? This is new. I'll read that in a second. We usually do lo-fi shit. I need some different jams today, though. What's another genre that would be nice, just chill music to have going on? I need something chill. I reached plat today. I'll run into you eventually. Hell yeah, dog. Hell yeah. Not lo-fi, please. It makes you sleep. It does. Electro swing? I can do electro swing. Electro swing works. Let's see. What would it be? I'm gonna look through the playlist here, and we'll see if we find any good ones. Like, there's a few basic ones, like, the best ones and stuff. Like, but let's see if there's like any other ones, you know? Like, Electro swing and jazz. All right. That sounds like it's probably chill. Let's try this out. All right. I'm already feeling it. Hell yeah. Nice. You read the mail about version 2.2? No. Whoa. Yo! Yami Bakura, dog! He's coming up! Hell yeah. And Yami Merrick's coming up soon, too. Hell yeah. All new Duelathon is coming. Fill up your duel meter to unlock a new character. Trying to scream a real spook is coming your way. Bones? Maybe?
Oh shit, I'm sorry.
Another duel is coming late December. Receive the Domino City Tin reward of a new character. Y'all invited to a show of nightmares that is. Let Battle City begin. Is that the weird dark magician kind of guy? Who had like the weird mask and stuff? You know who I'm talking about? He also had a dark magician. Arcana, is that him? That's dope. He has a lot of dark magician shit that I wanted. Niko Hime, thank you. What else we got? Wait, what? Oh no, never mind. I thought this was saying we were gonna get Roland as a character. Would have been amazing. All right, so in early January, all I desire is victory. I don't know who that would be. No clue. Shadow Neat, by the way, for 2 months. Thanks, man. Thanks for being awesome and making me laugh all the time. Favorite stream on Twitch. Thanks, dog. That was very nice of you. Shit. Alright. Nice. So, you guys might be wondering, hey, what's your progress like? I was, here, let me actually show you. I went through a lot of keys. I have 65 black keys left. That's a shit. I went through a lot of keys. I was grinding the Chazz. I kind of crushed all my keys. I won every time I dueled them though, when I was grinding. Let me see. Let me show you my progress on the Chazz deck. Here we go. So, we got three Ojama Knights. I got a Ojama Delta Hurricane.
Oh shit, I'm sorry.
And I think that was really it for the things we actually got from. We didn't get another Ojama Blue, even though we need two more. But I think that's really all we need is just another. Oh yeah, we also got another Ojama King. But yeah, we need two more Ojama Blues, and still we are not getting Ojama Blues. We're getting no luck. You need three blues, I know. It sucks. Makes me sad, considering we put all this work into it. So I'm gonna do one quick more roundabout with Joseph here. I'm doing it with Joseph because, I'm calling him Joseph, aren't I? I'm doing it with Joey because he has a card that he unlocks. Heart of the Underdog, I think. Which would be really good for that deck as well. So, this is our deck, by the way, in case you're curious. Is Ojama Magic in the game? I'm not sure. No, Ojama Muscle, I believe, is. I could be wrong on that, actually. I don't know. Hugh Charles, by the way. Thank you for 9 months. Dude, those cards look disturbing. How could you? Anyway, let's give it a shot. Should look cry. All I get are blues. I want blues. So I'll give you guys the basic rundown. I've gotten a lot better at this deck since we last did this. Cause last time we did this, I was like, what's happening? But I've consistently got this at least 15 times since that stream. Is gonna be another pack opening stream? I don't think so. Did you check the Duel Trader? Oh, actually, I don't think I've checked it since it updated. Thank you for reminding me. Alright, so right now we only have one of the things we need. So we can stall with these cards. Alright. Use a new mic? No! Is it bad? I hope not. Okay. Cyberstein, that can work. So hopefully he's gonna put down another guy on top of the fact that he's getting an Armed Dragon level 5, I believe? That's fine? Okay. Armed Dragon level 3 You sound better? Oh. Well, it might be closer. It's really the quality of mic gets better the closer I get to it. Like... Hey, does this sound good? Does this sound alright? Do I sound like a third grader still? But yeah, there you go. See? It's really just the closer it gets. That's how it goes. Was that ASMR? Oh shit. Okay, so we're getting really poor luck so far. I just need... Okay, another wall actually saves us. So Cyberstein is probably not going to be a method unless we get another draining shield. I'm going to just let him attack. Because he's going to summon the other guy again anyway. So we're not doing the Cyberstein rat this time. That's fine. We'll get the comeback with this. Can we have a nothing but attention to the stream, please? That'd be a nice stream, wouldn't it? Oh, he didn't do it. Huh. Well, shit. I wonder why he didn't do it. Well, there's Piranha Army. I guess now I just need something out on the field. I guess since I'm not doing this, I can just put him in defense mode. Just to make sure he doesn't do anything stupid. Alright, we're good. There's Dimension Hole. Alright, now we just need, Summoner of Illusions. Then we have everything we need. Which crap card is so good? Oh yeah, Wall Disruption is disgusting. It is a disgusting card. And it works off of itself, too, if you have two in the field. So you can lower everyone's shit by so much. And it's permanent, too. It's not just like a one-time thing. Alright, we're just waiting, really. Just gotta get the draw. Alright, there we go. We don't need that, actually. Tribute's not necessary, actually, anymore. We only need tribute when we, do Cyberstein's method. Tribute's a good one, though. There we go, we got Summoner. Okay, so we set Summoner. Use Dimension. I don't know why Dimension Hole is one word, but whatever. Okay. We do that. The next turn we win. Okay. So that comes back. We can flip summon. Summoner of Illusion. With his effect, we can tribute our Cyberstein and summon one fusion summon monster. And then we can summon a Piranha Army. And then we can activate Secret Pass to the Treasures. Use that on Piranha Army. So now he can attack directly. And his skill is when he attacks directly, he does double damage. Right now he only has 800. But with Gift of the Martyr, we can go ahead and sacrifice Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon and give his attack to Piranha Boy. So he can directly do a grand total of 10,600 damage. So that'll give us the comeback, and that'll give us the 9999, and hopefully we got this. The combos. Come on! Fuck! God damn it. I've got zero blue Ojamas from this motherfucker. I have a question for people who actually play this game. For future, level 30 Chazz only has one level 5 armed dragon. Oh, really? I did not know that. Alright, here's a question. Is it worth it? Oh, wait. Okay, let me check his updates. Okay, cast enter another super vice. Bountiful Artemis. Each time a counter card is activated, draw one card immediately after it resolves. Flash Assailant. Decrease the attack and defense of this card by 400 for each card in your hand. Uh-huh. Drive Teleporter. This card cannot be special summon. You can pay 2,000 life points to special summon two level 3 psychic types from your deck. Uh-huh. Botanical Girl. When this card is sent from the field to the graveyard, you can add one plant type monster with 1,000 less defense or less defense from your deck to your hand. Gate Guardian! This card's very good. It's a very good card. It's not really. $9 bagel, by the way. Thanks, man. When will we ever... I don't know, man. So, here's the thing with Gate Guardian. You got a tribute. Sangha, Kaizogen, and Suijin. They all have to be on the field at the same time. They're all three two-tributed monsters, right? They all have like 2400 attack-ish, roughly, somewhere around there, 24, 26. They also have a pretty solid effect, right? This motherfucker doesn't even have an effect. He's just a 3750 beater. That's it. Arsenal bug. If you control another insect monster's card loses some shit. Okay, so if you have... It's not bad. Magna slash dragon. You can send one face-up continuous spell card you control to your graveyard. Destroy one spell trap card on your opponent's side of the field. Okay. Victory thing. This is one of those things that... Wait, actually, what is this? If this card destroys an opponent's monster by battle active one of these effects, this card gains 400 attack. Destroy one face-up spell or trap card in the field to destroy that card, that target. Special summon one option token. Its type, attribute, level, attack, and defense are always the same as this card. Huh. Well, it's only 1200, so I don't really know. But $9 bagel, though. Thanks, man. And let's see. Life Force Harmonizer. That's terrifying. When your opponent activates a card effect that inflicts damage, you can discard this card, negate its activation, and destroy it. Yami. Ambush of Ares, Gravel Storm. Damn, nothing really. Okay, here's the question I was going to ask. Is it worth it to trade in the normal keys that I got for these keys? Because I only have 37 of these keys, and I'd get just 10 for 100 of them. I don't know if that's actually even worth. Is it? Because I don't know. I don't know what else I should really think about. Running out? Okay, so yeah. Good. Wait, they're sold out? I can't buy more than just 10? Oh, shit! Well, that sucks. I thought I could just keep buying more. That's awkward. Well, fuck. I think we can only do one more. Can you show the first card artwork look really good? Alright, dog, I got you. I got you. Oh, fuck, hold on. I got you. Chaos Hunter? Bam. When your opponent special summons a monster except during the damage step, you discard one card, special summon this card from your hand. Your opponent cannot banish cards. That's not bad, actually. Huh. Not bad. Alright, anyway. We'll do one more with this, and then we'll fiddle with stuff. Because we can't do any more after this anyway. So we'll just get the last one out of the way, and then we'll figure it out. Maybe we'll level up. I don't know. Maybe we'll do ranked. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Paradox Brothers have a skill that lets you start with three guardians, but you have only one gate guardian in hand. 500 life points, and they can't attack. What a strange thing. Alright. Here we go. This is a better starting hand. We can survive this. I mean, we don't have anything that we need, but we don't have any issue with surviving this whatsoever. More packs? We don't need more packs. Wait, I am using my deck. Okay. Alright, so hopefully... So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put that in defense mode. So he'll be more likely to attack it with this, probably. Yep, okay. With that, we'll do a draining shield. Then we can do Cyberstein. Alright. So we'll do a Cyberstein this time around so you guys can see the other method. With that, though, we're gonna need to get a tribute to make it work. Cry Valhalla, me a drink that burns tastes so good. The hell did you say, M-Sharp? 2000. This will bring us down to 1600, so we're still in the clear. There's gift. Okay. This game is hard. You just gotta understand the cards. It's not that bad. But he uses only level 5, and according to our main man that is in chat, that is aiding us through all of our ventures, because he's always in chat when we're doing this, he only has one. So we're okay.
Oh,
so epic, Bree. Thanks, man. Alright, there's another wall. I might as well just put it down, I guess. No reason not to. Read that better, you doof. No! I don't want to! Okay. Now we need, Tribute and a Piranha. Okay. There's Tribute. We're gonna have to just get rid of that. So deck list for this, because it's great for LP farming. I will show you right after this, just remind you, okay? Alright, there we go. So, oh wait, no, we don't got Dimension Hole. Fuck, we still need Dimension Hole. No, no we don't. We can just do it right now. Wait, no we can't. Alright, we'll just wait for Dimension Hole. That's fine. It's just to be safe. Because otherwise he could potentially kill it. I gotta let him kill this thing. If he doesn't kill it, then I'm fucked. Go on. Oh, wait a second. No, we're fine, we're fine. Draining shields. Get rid of this guy. Come on, baby. Dimension. That's not Dimension.